We got a pretty nice crowd today. I was kind of surprised. Yeah. On the Facebook page, it was like 18 or 20 people said they were coming. But yeah, we got...
There was a lot of interest, though.
Yeah. Yeah, we got like 30-something here, or almost 40. If you count the people that aren't in the room yet, but... Ready? Go! Yeah, this matchup is kind of similar to Marth Puff, except obviously the big thing is the needles and then the lingering hitboxes from Sheik to make things a little bit easier.
Here, I gotta tell Darius something. That's Jobs and that's Ben. It's mixed up.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it's, we got it. Interesting strategy.
What's Ben doing? He's like jumping on the platform.
Well, that's one way to bait out a rest, I guess. Throw the chain out and wave dash back. Oh, wow. Nice. Oh. Good combos. We got the percent almost evened up. Now it's just whoever gets the next back air. There's one. Back to back air war.
One thing I think Jobs is going to be looking for is crouching underneath Sheik's grab.
Yep.
Because Puff can crouch under a lot of grabs, so she has a really good crouch.
Yeah, you know he's looking for it because that's how he got the first stock. And
yeah, he rested after crouching. Ben knows he can't grab, but sometimes you have to. You just have to, like, pick the right position to do it. In the right time.
I thought it was really cool how, I can't remember what major it was at, but it was one of the majors where Wizzy took a game off, or took a set off H-Box. He didn't use a single grab the entire set until the very last stock of the very last game.
I think that was What the Fox.
Yeah, that is what it was.
This is a 3-0 by Wizzy.
Yeah.
That's like one of my favorite sets of the entire tournament.
Yeah, it was fantastic.
Joe's going for a lot of rest.
Yeah, I wonder what that's about. I mean, maybe he... I mean, a lot of times what happens if you get a rest early on and you got one on the first stock, you'll be looking for it where it's not there the rest of the match.
Yeah.
It's all about mental fortitude. Like, you have to realize what got you that first one. And the first one he got by that crouch that you were talking about, and it seems like he's been going for a lot of rest off of nothing, and he's been whiffing them. It's cost him a couple stocks now.
A lot of needle camping.
Yeah.
It's kind of like, it works.
Yeah.
Sometimes really, like, he just platform cancels needles. Over
yeah, these needles and tilts at the lower percents, and then now you see that he's got them up to about 50, starts turning his back to him.
Yeah. I think down throw up air might kill at this percent.
Yeah, I think you're right.
And Jobs can't rest anymore, because if he rests, Ben can DI it to the blast zone and come back and then get the punish and he'll die.
Yeah, up smash will, pretty sure that'll kill. Down smash. It works.
Rest is back on the table because it's last stock.
Looks like Ben just wants to get a little bit more damage with needles. Maybe look for a back air instead of going for something riskier. Now he's in the corner.
Oh no! Oh,
unfortunate SD, but that's just game one.
Yeah.
And he was looking pretty commanding throughout most of that game. So hopefully that SD doesn't get to his head and he can come back and clean up.
Ben's really good on the stage.
Same way the first game started.
Commentator's curse.
Yeah.
I might be, yeah, see, like, rest like that.
Yeah.
Should go for it. I might be mistaken, but Ben said he money matched Gary recently, and it was 3-1, and he said, like, he lost every game, but four stocked him on this stage.
Oh my gosh.
But jokes. Got to really rest.
Yeah, that's a pretty big confidence booster if you know you've forced out a player here before.
I might be mistaken, but I know he beat him on this stage pretty solidly.
He's having a little bit of trouble getting rid of this first stock, though. Great ledge grab.
Wow.
Down smash.
I never got your tag.
Oh, it's a lag.
Lag?
Yeah, because that's my John. Whenever I lose, it's because the TV's lagging. Well, good trade. And just like that, he takes the stock lead.
Yeah, even though he got the rest, Ben clawed it back. Now he has a slight lead.
Dash attack, really powerful, but Randall was in the right place at the right time. That'll do it, so tied up.
Two stocks to two. Only a 34% lead.
Ben's doing a great job keeping him out.
Oh. I think he was looking for a rest.
Yeah.
I think if Ben wins this, we're gonna probably go to Battlefield because Joke already won on Fountain.
Yeah.
And Ben will probably strike Dreamland.
Yeah, I think you're right. Trade. Both make it back. At this point, I would, you know, I'm no expert, but I would want to be looking for a back air from Sheik, just because Puff is at 100%. But it seemed like he was looking for a forward air, maybe a grab in the up air. But
if Jobes wins this, it's actually going to be a pretty big upside. Ben usually doesn't lose to players, like, not saying Jobes is that far beneath Ben,
yeah,
but players of, like, Jobes' caliber.
See, right there, Jobes really wanted to grab a shield, but it didn't fall for it, so I don't think that we're going to get a crouch rest to end this game. Yeah, see, he's not up tilt rest. Wow. Oh, a little bit of a problem.
Good stuff, Jobes.
Yeah, nice.
That's a really good win.
There was quite a crowd at the end of that.
So I think next we have Lexor versus Aggro God. Aggro God plays Ice Climbers. And
okay.
Lexor plays a wide range of characters, but usually he plays Vox.
Yeah, I've had the pleasure to play Lexor at the University of St. Thomas a number of times. He's definitely number one, I'd say, at UST. But there are a couple other people that are pretty close to him, but he always manages to edge it out. His best character is Vox, but like you said, he's got a great Sheik.
And he's got a good Falco.
Yeah. He has a really bad Puff, but
I know he uses Sheik against Samus.
Yeah. He also has played Sheik against Marth, but his Fox is just as good against Marth.
Yeah, Lexor's brought in Ben pretty close multiple times, but Ben always clutches it out.
Yeah. I haven't seen him play Ice Climbers pretty much at all, though. But I know
Aggro God or I guess it's Indigo.
Or I mean Lexor play against Ice Climbers.
He might have changed his tag because last time he entered the monthly it was Aggro God, I'm pretty sure, but now it's Indigo.
Interesting.
I like that tech where Aggro God kind of just...
Oh, yeah. That's funny because Smash God has just changed his tag to Rishi recently. And I wonder if it has something to do with God being in both those tags. It's kind of, I don't know if people think it's unprofessional or something, but... Either way, I'm down with it.
I'm pretty sure this is a... Is this a hand? Yeah, it's a hand.
Yeah, it is.
Because, like, they were, like, warming up, and then they're, like, fighting, so...
Or I think it's... Yeah.
I might be wrong.
I'm not sure. They were warming up. Okay, yeah, it is. Lexer's got a pretty good tech skill with Fox. He's definitely he's the best player and the best with tech skill at UST. But the only thing is, and I don't know if he's changed this, last time I played him, which was a few months ago, he didn't know how to wave dash backward, or wave shine backwards. Like you can see right now, he's always wave dashing out of a shine forward. Something about the timing is just something that he...
Yeah, you have to turn around and
He's like never been able to get it down.
What character do you play?
I play Marth Falco, but I have a sucky fox. I like the